like, hi, I'm Michael Valgren, writer for Tinkoff Saxo. This is my NeoPro diary for inCycle, or just...
No, you can just say this is my NeoPro diary.
Ah, okay. That's fine. Yeah. Just now?
Whenever, yeah.
Okay. Hi, I'm Michael. Now I'm getting nervous, you know, now I have a line. That's not good. That's why I didn't become an actor.
Ever since his days as a NeoPro, inCycle have been following Michael Valgren's career closely. 6 years later, and with the Dane established as one of the best classics riders in the world, we met with the NTT rider to discuss his rise to stardom, including his big breakthrough victory at the 2018 Omloop at Nieuwsblad.
To win the Omloop was like unbelievable, to be honest. Like, opening weekend, you know, I maybe didn't realize myself how big it was to win the opening weekend in Belgium, you know, the home of cycling and the fans. And ever since, I hear people, you know, yell my name, oh, that's the winner from the Omloop, you know. That's just, that's super cool. For sure, that race, that changed my career, like also my mindset, that now I want to be the best in the classics. I want to show people that I'm a classics rider.
Left-hand side for Astonage, Michael Valgren and Anderson to go. Valgren the Dane, the winner of Omloop at Nieuwsblad, and he has so much power. He has time to celebrate. It's Michael Valgren for Astonage who wins at the Amstel Gold Race.
2018, I think I was just like kind of walking on water. Like whatever I did was the right decision. So, because maybe I wasn't in such a good shape in Omloop actually. But then I kind of built it up towards Amstel Gold Race as I won, like being fourth in Tour Flanders. So I think that year, without knowing what I actually did, I just did everything right. Where some years you, whatever reason or like decision you take is maybe the wrong one, you know, though you think it's the right one. So some years I think it's just like that.
2019 ultimately proved to be one of those difficult seasons for the 28-year-old, following a move to the team now known as NTT Pro Cycling. And with his old Tinkoff Saxo manager and compatriot Bjarne Riis in charge, the Dane is looking forward to a bright future with the squad.
Bjarne Riis joining the team is pretty exciting, you know, me being a Dane and I know Bjarne from the past, so even though we didn't work together that much, we still kept in touch after. I think Bjarne, he saw, or maybe still see, like some kind of star in me, and that's why we kept texting each other. So it's super nice to have him on board and that he will work with me. So I think we can make some good things happen. Bjarne, he likes to watch people and like now when we were training, he really observed. And And one day he came to me and in the car, he used to sit like this in the car and look. And then he'd be like, oh, I can come here. And he tells me, you look really great. It's like, oh, you know, that's big words from Bjarne. So already there, I think it's a big step forward already in 2020.
Pop that over to you. And then if you could just press play in the corner.
Yeah. Oh, heck. I know I still look young, but now when I see these pictures, I look even younger. So, no, I changed a lot, like my mentality and just the whole lifestyle about being professional. I think back in these days, I like my bike, but it's not like now where. Now, actually, I love my bike. I cannot imagine without like a day without training or anything. It's funny to see my girlfriend or wife. I think it's good that sometimes during a race day I have got my kicked, so I don't think I'm Superman right away and I have to work for it. My mind is clear now that I have to work 100% all the time to be in the with the best, and if not, then yeah, forget about it. I think back then I was still so young, and I'm not so good in like the history of cycling or the races, so I'm not even sure back then I knew what omelette was, to be honest. but like, just to win in the highest level was not something I was thinking back of then, back then, because I was still so young and new to this. So I'm super happy and super privileged to be here today, because how many professionals are we out there? Maybe 500-600 on the world tour. It's not a lot of people compared to how many there actually is on the bike. So I'm happy to be here.